If you've noticed a small patch of sky that's sparkly with stars, you may have been looking at the Pleiades, which is one of the most beautiful star clusters and the most easy to see with your unaided eyes. If you do your star watching in the evening, you can find the Pleiades any time from late autumn to early spring, so you have lots of time to become an expert. Behind us, we have a scene from the computer program Stellarium, and it's set for early in the month of December. Can you find the Pleiades? Stars are born in clusters, and over time they drift apart. So if you see a group of stars that's still in its cluster, they must be young stars, and the Pleiades is only about 100 million years old. Do you see it? If you think that's the Pleiades, you are right. When the Pleiades are rising, they're in the east, above the bright star Aldebaran, and to the right of another bright star, Capella. One tip for observing the Pleiades is, of course, to go out when the sky is very clear and very dark. It helps to get away from city lights, but even in a city sky, the light from the Pleiades shines through. Oh, here we have the sky set for November 28th, and I see that the moon will be near the Pleiades. And when that happens, the Pleiades isn't looking its best, and that happens a few days out of every 29 or 30 days in the lunar cycle. But the Pleiades is still there, and if you look, I think you can still find it. Now we're back under a dark sky. And under a dark sky, the Pleiades can be used as a kind of eye test. How many stars can you count among the stars of the Pleiades? Most people can count 6. If you have sharp eyes, you can probably count more. The funny thing is that in some old stories, the Pleiades is named after 7 sisters. And if your eyes are sharp enough to count 7 stars, I think you could probably count 9 stars. If you're using the Pleiades as a test of your eyesight, it gives you a chance to practice an astronomical observation technique called averted vision. The center of our field of view is very good at seeing detail and color in bright light, but it's not so good at catching the dim light, like light from dim stars. Around the edge of our field of view, our eyes are more sensitive to dim light. So when you use averted vision, you look at an object and then you look off to the side. Then you might be able to see that object more easily. If you're trying it on your computer screen looking at the Pleiades, it's not going to work. You have to look at the real thing to use averted vision correctly. And will it be easier to see more stars in the Pleiades using averted vision? Well, it takes a little practice. Probably most of us have trained our brains to concentrate on the thing that our eyes are looking at. And paying attention to something that's off to the side of whatever we're looking at takes a little practice, a little retraining. But if you do it, you may be able to see more stars in the Pleiades more easily. When you look at the Pleiades, you might wonder whether the sky around that patch is glowing or whether it's just an illusion from all of those pinpoints of light. Well, actually, the sky around it does have a cloudiness of light, an aura, that's caused by dust near those stars, and the starlight from all of the stars in the Pleiades is lighting up that dust so that we can see it. People used to think that that dust was left over from the formation of the Pleiades, but now by analyzing how the stars are moving and the structure of that dust cloud, scientists think that's just one of many clouds of dust that's moving through space and happens to be moving near the Pleiades right now. If you'd like to get to know the Pleiades better, you could start to learn the names of some of these stars. You can start with the bright star in the middle, Alcyone. At the east end, you have Maia and Electra, or more by itself over here, the star Atlas, which is like the stem of the letter P. P, you can imagine that's for Pleiades. If I could see through your eyes, I wonder how many stars I could see.